Today I'm going to talk about how to break the output for the Nema 17 steppers into two steppers from one stepper driver board. In order to do that, I got purchased a small little product here that'll divide it into two. So there's one input that goes to the one input of the axis that you want to break in two, and then it gives you two outputs for each one of your steppers. In a moment, I'll give you a closer look at this and how to set it up. Okay, to set it up, it's really simple. We have a notched cable, so we're just gonna plug it in as if we were plugging in a regular stepper, and then we're gonna plug it in the axis of our choice. In this case, we're gonna use the Y axis, but it obviously can be used for either the X or the Z as well. So that's all you have to do to set it up. And then what you're gonna do is take your input for your Nema, plug it in on the one side, and then plug it in for the other. In a moment, I'll show you how to connect the USB and then connect to the computer. Okay, we need to connect the USB serial cable in order to load the firmware. So the big end goes in the board like so. The small one goes into the computer and you're gonna hear a beep. Now keep in mind, you can't touch this area once it's been energized by the power from the USB. So in a moment, I'm gonna show you how to load the Marlin firmware. Okay, the first thing we're gonna do is open up the Marlin folder for 1.1.8. We're then gonna open up the Marlin subfolder. We're gonna press M on the keyboard and scroll down to Marlin .ino and hit enter. Inside the Marlin folder, we're going to go to configuration.h. We're going to search on motherboard. And what we have here is motherboard. We have the board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB. Now the architecture for the MKS Gen L and the ramps 1.4 are exactly the same, so we're going to leave that alone. So now we're going to search on default underscore axis underscore steps underscore per underscore unit. And what we have here is the breakout of the X, Y, and Z. And then of course we have extruders and additional extruders if you so choose. But in this case, we're not concerned with changing anything because this is just to show the device that we've connected. So I'm gonna show you how to load the firmware instead. So first we're gonna go to tools. We're gonna go to the COM port, make sure it's selected, which it appears to be. And then we're gonna go over to the compile and upload button over here and let it upload. And in a moment, I'll show you in Pronterface and on the MKS Gen L how the dual stepper actually works. Okay, off camera, I attached the 12 volt power supply. It's not plugged in, obviously. And I also unplugged the 5 volt to do it. So I'm gonna plug it back in for the 5 volts for USB. Remember, you can't touch this area once there's power running through it. That includes 5 volts and the 12 volt power supply. So now I'm plugging in the power supply. It's energized, so this is unsafe to touch. And in a moment, I'll show you how these steppers work in Pronterface. Okay, what we're gonna do is we're gonna open up Pronterface. We're gonna connect to the actual 3D printer board. Now I'm going to move the axis by 10 and show you what happens. Now I'm going to move the axis by 100 so you can see what happens again. So if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.